गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टीचिंग चैप्टर 14 एंड नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर 14 इज़ द केमिकल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। Chemical effects of electric current. You know that a liquid which conduct electric current and at the same time undergoes a chemical change is due to the chemical effect of electric current. Let us perform the following activity. In this we will discuss about activity 14.4 and name of the activity to show chemical reaction takes place when electric current is passed through common salt solution in water. Materials required: a cup shaped voltmeter with platinum electrodes, common salt solution in distilled water, matchbox, 6 volt battery, switch. Methods: take the given voltmeter. It consists of a cup-shaped glass vessels from the bottom of which arise 2 platinum electrodes. And these electrodes are connected to the brass terminals fixed on the wooden base. You can see in the diagram, it is given on diagram page number 14.6. To show chemical effects of electric current, and fill 3/4 of the voltmeter with water containing dissolved common salt, and the dissolved common salt makes the water electrically conducting, and fill each of the test tube of the voltmeter with common salt solution and then invert them over the platinum electrodes shown in figure 14.6, and taking care that no water flows out of them. This can be achieved by placing the thumb on the mouth of test tube and then removing the thumb under the common salt solution in the voltmeter. You can see in the diagram that a voltmeter, and it consists of cup shaped glass vessels, and from its bottom 2 platinum electrodes are there. And these electrodes are connected to the brass terminals, and this is fixed on the wooden base. And then you will observe that tiny bubbles of colorless gas arise from both the electrodes and collect in the test tube. Furthermore, the gas collected at the negative terminal of the battery is twice in volume as compared to the gas collected at the positive terminal of the battery. And the gas collected on the negative terminal of the battery is the hydrogen gas. The gas what is collected on the negative terminal, that is called the hydrogen gas. And the gas can be easily tested by bringing a burning match stick near the mouth of the test tube, and the gas catches fire when the loud pop sound at the match stick goes off. And the gas collected on the positive terminal of the battery, that is the oxygen gas, negative terminal, that is the hydrogen gas, and positive terminal, that is the oxygen gas. And this gas can be easily tested by introducing the glowing end of the matchstick in the test tube when the matchstick bursts into flame. And water, this is the water, electric current hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. How does the electric current bring about chemical change in water? a very very small amount of water decomposes on its own to form positively charged hydrogen H plus ions and negatively charged hydroxyl ions. And however, their number remains same and hence the water remains electrically neutral. And when electric current is passed through water, hydrogen ions are attracted towards negatively charged terminal and here they gain electric charge to form neutral hydrogen atoms, and the hydrogen atoms subsequently join to form hydrogen molecules. And conversely, on the passage of electric current, hydroxyl ions are attracted towards positively charged terminal and here they lose electric charges to form neutral hydroxyl ions which unite to form the oxygen gas. Now come to the general terms associated with the passage of current through the solution. First one is the electrolyte. What is the electrolyte? An aqueous solution of chemical compound which conducts electric current and at the same time undergoes a chemical change is called the electrolyte. What is the electrolyte? An aqueous solution of a chemical compound which conducts electric current and at the same time undergoes a chemical change is called the electrolyte. Examples: aqueous solution of all acids such as HCl, HNO3, H2SO4, etc. Aqueous solution of all alkalis, that is NaOH, KOH. Aqueous solution of soluble salts, that is the common salt, copper sulfate, sodium nitrate and zinc chloride. So what is the electrolyte? It is the aqueous solution of chemical compound which conduct the electric currents and at the same time undergoes a chemical change is called the electrolyte. What is a non-electrolyte? A solution of a chemical compound, which does not conduct electric current, and hence does not undergo any chemical change is called non-electrolyte. What is a non-electrolyte? A solution of a chemical compound which does not conduct electric current and hence does not undergo any chemical change is called non-electrolyte. What is the examples? Petrol, kerosene oil, diesel oil, vegetable oil, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, alcohol, ether, benzene, distilled water, etc. What is the term electrolysis? Electrolysis, the process due to which a solution of chemical compound conducts electric current at the same time undergoes a chemical change. A solution of chemical compound conducts electric current and undergoes a chemical change takes place. This is called the electrolysis. Electrodes, the metal wires, plates, rods through which the current enters or leaves, and electrolyte are called the electrodes. Cathode, the electrode connected to the negative terminal of the battery is called the cathode. Anode, the electrode connected to the positive terminal of the vessel or the battery is called the anode. Ions, the electrically charged atoms, groups of atoms formed when a chemical compound is dissolved in water are called ions. Cations, the positively charged ions formed when a chemical compound dissolved in water are called the cations. During electrolysis, the cations are discharged at cathode by taking electric charges from it. Anions, the negatively charged ions formed when a chemical compound dissolved in water are called the anions. During electrolysis, the anions are discharged at anode by losing electric charges to it. What is a voltmeter? An apparatus in which electrolysis is carried out such that it consists of a vessel, two electrodes and electrolyte is called the voltmeter. So till here you will take revision. Today I discussed about the chemical effects of electric currents and activity 14.4 and electrolyte, non-electrolyte and electrolysis, electrodes, cathode, anode, ions, cations, anions and voltmeter. So all of you take revision till here, and tomorrow we will discuss about electroplating. What is the electroplating? And today till here you will take revision.